Coming up next on ATETV. Game development and simulation.
It's great learning, you know, programming and learning graphic design and actually seeing the stuff that we're doing instead of just, you know, imagining, and you can bring all your imagination to life, and it's just an amazing experience.
Green building technology.
What you'll find in these classes, you'll find a lot of people that are actually in the field that have some hands-on experience that they're willing to share with the class.
And wind energy technology.
Wind energy is an important career track because of climate change regulations. People are more interested in renewable energy. It's kind of a cutting edge sort of field.
Now on ATETV. Across the country to your own backyard, ATETV shows you the many advanced technological education opportunities available at your local community college. Do you like video games? Maybe you've even thought about designing and creating your own game. Let's meet Brian Simpson, a student in the Simulation and Game Development program at Wake Technical Community College, who's doing just that.
My name is Brian Simpson. I'm a student at Wake Tech for video game design. It's the SGD program. It's simulation and game development. It's, you know, a passion of mine. I like just sitting at home, drawing up designs and figuring out what I can do with video games. And you know, it's really hard having to, you know, do a lot of math in my head and, you know, do a lot of writing out. And it's great learning, you know, programming and learning graphic design and actually seeing the stuff that we're doing instead of just, you know, imagining. And you can bring all your imagination to life, and it's just an amazing experience.
If you just click on it a couple times, the piece that you want to work with, and that way you can get by the group and you can just select the piece.
Thank you. Whoa. Makes everything great.
Yes.
So far I've had a lot of fun with 3D modeling. It's kind of difficult. You know, the program's very pristine. If, you know, you move the wrong direction or use the wrong tool, it kind of throws your model off, or you don't get your proportions right. But, you know, it's a lot of fun seeing what, you know, everyone can do. And students will come up to you and they'll work with you, and the teachers will come up to you and work with you and throwing out ideas for this and that, and, you know, saying, well, you know, what if you take this model and, you know, tweak it just a little bit, or, you know, add this weapon or make it this much bigger, or, you know, this lighting to it that adds just the perfect effects for the perfect scenario. Great. I've been actually working on a video game of mine for the past couple of years. I'd like to keep working on that and hopefully get a job in, with any kind of video game company I can. Just get out there, get in the field. Even if I'm not getting paid, if I can just get an internship and just see everything runs and work with that and, you know, build off of that, it would be, I mean, amazing. The SGD program, Simulation Game Design, it's the place to be.
Brian Simpson is using his time at Wake Tech as an opportunity to be creative and acquire useful and marketable technical skills. If this sounds like something you'd be interested in, be sure to check out your local community college. Maybe you're just starting out and are interested in green building technologies. Or maybe you've been working in the building industry for a while and are looking to go back to school to upgrade your skills. Community colleges have programs that are designed just for you. Let's take a look.
It's that much of a trade-off savings?
Code-wise it is. I'm not going to say energy-wise it is, but code-wise it is.
We've had some people who have been in the building industry for a number of years, but when they find out how much they can benefit from weatherization programs, they're amazed.
Insulation, limited space heating, air conditioning, and water heating requirements.
That's why you see a diverse range of age in our population, because many of these people in these weatherization programs are coming to St. Clair for training.
I think St. Clair is a fantastic opportunity. I'm 58 years old, planning on a second career.
So I'll get dimensions and windows, somebody on that side, you two. John, you want to go to the back side?
Yeah. What you'll find in these classes, you'll find a lot of people that are actually in the field that have some hands-on experience that they're willing to share with the class. So I learn a lot from the faculty, and I learn a whole lot from my fellow students as well.
Do you have to stand in one place, or do you move around the
room? You can move around the room.
Okay. We encourage students to work together, help each other.
Yeah, go ahead and take it across.
The flow in CFS.
In many of my classes, I have older students and younger students work together quite well.
I found my experience with the younger students very enjoyable. They're bright, young, excited about getting started. So it's been very enjoyable, almost inspiring at times.
Yeah, try that.
The older people bring life experience to the classroom. And that adds a lot to it. Makes things very, very realistic.
The problem is you got to put your sheathing higher, so you got more sighting on and more sheathing.
I wouldn't say I have one specific mentor that helped me get to this stage or helped push me in this direction. I just feel like it's a learning community and that it's really great.
Community college programs often have a broad and diverse range of students. And that diversity creates a supportive learning approach and helps students develop team building and technical skills and prepares them for the workforce or higher education. Interested in the renewable energy field? How about a high demand career that is full of challenges? The Wind Technology Program at Laramie County Community College could be the right place for you to start your climb. Take a look.
Wind energy is an important career track because of climate change regulations. People are more interested in renewable energy. It's kind of a cutting edge sort of field.
Those little weights fly out as a result of centrifugal force, disconnecting the start winding from the circuit.
Somebody who's had formalized training certainly has a leg up on the typical wind technician right now, since it's such a new field.
How come we have a resistance difference in the start winding? Because the wire size is smaller.
In the last about 4 years, you've seen exponential growth throughout the industry. It's growing so rapidly that the manpower, the knowledge, the expertise that we're reaching out for is very difficult to fill.
Take this wire off too.
We're searching adamantly for people across the country.
And I'm going to turn the power back on.
Our relationship with Laramie County Community College began during construction of the facility. We allowed the wind technology students to come out to the site, look around. The wind technology students all have to be trained in high angle rescue, and so they came out and used our facility as a training ground.
He's controlling his own descent just like you see some of these rock climbers do.
Careers available at some place like Duke Energy might be working in our development office, an engineer in design, construction management.
Now where's the main shaft break? Yeah, it's right here.
The kind of training that LCCC is giving their students, like AC-DC circuits, mechanical systems, computer programming, they're all the sort of training that Duke Energy is looking for in a potential employee.
Easy on drive motors, and I actually have two different types of
AC. Those that are attending these new colleges are definitely being looked at.
Actually, when you think about that, which side's the active flank?
Education that they will receive here is top notch. I don't know if you can get it better anywhere else from my experience.
Wow, some incredible opportunities. And not just in the wind power industry. Community colleges all across the country have strong regional industry and business relationships that keep courses up to date and can lead to great jobs. If you want to find out more about wind energy technology or want more information on anything you've seen today, explore our website at ATETV.org. Thanks for watching.